Oh, hello there. I didn't see ya.
Hi, my name is Jake, and today I'm feeling just a little bit shy. Button.tk, that is Dong. In this episode of Dong, we're going back to our roots to do some classic donging. Things that you can do online now, guys. On andrewpeckler.com/phantom-islands, you can explore a map full of islands whose existences have never been verified because either they never existed or they don't exist now. The latter can happen because of natural disasters like earthquakes or volcanic eruptions, while the first can be due to a multitude of reasons, including misidentification of things like icebergs. And we can check out these reasons using the map as well as learn the history while listening to the soundscapes of these phantom islands. Let's check out Bus Island, located near Greenland. This is one of the most persistent phantom islands and appeared on nautical maps into the 19th century. There are several theories as to why this phantom island was believed to exist. One possibility is the mirage Fata Morgana, more common in the northern waters that can make things look like they're floating. Pretty eerie. As Atlantic traffic increased, there were fewer and fewer accounts of seeing the Bus Island, and it became clear that it was no longer there, if it ever was. And just as you're wondering where the islands went, you might be wondering, where does the day go? If sleep takes around 7 hours of your day, you might be wondering, what happens with the other 17? Or what could happen? You can refresh right here to see the different ways you could spend your days, like watching 7 full-length NBA games with commercials, or read Cat in the Hat by Dr. Seuss 125 times. If you're a speed reader, maybe you could do 126, maybe 127, who knows, you're talented. On this site, you can see how you spend or waste your time. All right. First, use these sliders to determine how much of your time is spent at work, at home, and sleeping. Now let's get more specific. How much time do you spend eating and commuting to work? Now, how many times do you check your phone? Well, look what happens to your day if you check it every 10 minutes. Finish filling it out, and at the end, it'll either terrify or delight you to know how much time you actually spend being productive. But if you're like me, you probably spend a lot of your time writing poems like haikus. Well, good news, you no longer have to do it unassisted, a super fun dong to write glorious poems without all the stress. Let us please begin, fill in each cute little box, write me a poem. Taco, a haiku by DJ Lasagna. Blistery leaping, a furry taco trample out of spaghetti. Now that we've read a poem full of words, like most poems, let's play a word association game, Semantris. There are two ways to play, either timed or not. With blocks, you have time to think and try your best to guess words that you think the AI would associate with one of the blocks. Whichever block it chooses will knock out those touching it of the same color. Let's try. Play blocks. Skip tutorial, because I'm an adult. Forest, boom, trees. Also farm would kind of work for that. Oh, I did it. Flute, bicycle, sure, why not? Okay, mosquito, we will do annoying. See if it knows it. Oh wow, it did. Oh, no it didn't. Game, song. Who's your favorite musician, Hannah? Done, Dave Matthews Band. Hey, rain, I guess, was the correct answer there. So that's blocks. There's also arcade mode, and it's very fun, but you kind of got to panic a little bit because it's time. Let's do this one, I guess, too. Ready? Go. Here we go. Football. Okay. Sports. I know sports. I'm a athlete or something. Song. Dave Math. No, we learned that one didn't work. Song. Singing. Boom. Here we go. We are crushing it. Newspaper. Article. Boom. Ooh. Feel it. Toothbrush. Hygiene. Boom. Museum. Art. Thunder. Cloud. No. Cloud. Boom. Woo. Woo. Sorry, I can't stop now, Hannah. Lemon. Juice. Monday. Juice. Potato, juice, whoa, it worked. Bowling, water, sports, color, red, backpack, triangle, shape, school, woo, 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 no! Oh, look at that, fourth place. Dong, oh, Don, well, I guess Don got fourth place. Good job, Don. All right, that was riveting. And I really loved all the pretty colors of motion. This site is super cool for those of you interested in cinematography and color in movies. What it does is it calculates the average color per frame of a film and stacks them from top to bottom. This way you are able to see how color changes throughout a movie. You can search by director, title, genre, and year. Andrew Stanton directed the movie Finding Nemo in WALL-E, but let's focus on Finding Nemo. If we put it in here, we can notice that there's a lot more blue and green in Finding Nemo, which makes a lot of sense. But let's go to the Harry Potter series. We can see how the color has changed from the first movie to the last. Is it fascinating or is it not? That is a pun written by the wonderful Hannah Canetti. Oh, let's all give her a round of applause. Great work, Hannah. We're all proud of you. Now, I was supposed to have some rope or twine or something here to demonstrate how to do some knots, but I don't. So you can go to animatedknots.com to find out how, and if you don't have string, that's fine. There's something else that you can play with.
Wait. It's so heavy.
Is the latest Curiosity Box. This is box number 9. If you don't know what the Curiosity Box is, Michael, Kevin, and I make this thing every quarter, and it's a box full of learning, of curiosity, of science, toys, physics-based things, t-shirts, books, games, all fun, interesting, brain-feeding stuff. And what I'm really excited about, and I know Michael and Kevin are as well, is that a portion of the proceeds from every box goes to Alzheimer's research. And so far, we've been able to donate over $100,000 because of this box. This is actually our 2-year anniversary box, so we did a whole new branding on it. It has these big Roman numerals right there that say what number box it is. And the whole thing's this very sleek, kind of almost matte black finish to it with a little bit of texture on it. I'm very excited about it. I can't show you what's in the box because that would ruin it. But it's very cool. If you want to get your own, curiositybox.com. There'll be a link down there, as well as links to all the other dongs that we talked about in a playlist right here, full of them. So yeah, I hope you like this box. We spend a lot of time putting it together, and we design all the products besides the books, because those are written by other people. But they are exclusive to us in a very unique way, which we'll find out if you get this baby. So yeah, it should be shipping soon, or by the time this video comes out, it might already be. Anyway, that's my sales pitch on it. It really is something that we care about, and we do make it ourselves. It's not like a brand deal or anything. It's ours. We create it, and hopefully you enjoy it. All right, I love you, and as always, thanks for watching.